So today we're going to be talking about this Netflix movie that, you know.
Is your favorite in the whole wide world?
Ugh, please. Anyway, I'm Jay.
This is Lady. How are you guys?
Once again, you're tuned in to
Geek by Heart.
By Heart.
Exactly. All right.
And we're going to be talking about Netflix's
Thunder Force.
Thunder Force. Yeah, we're going to talk about it.
Let's talk about it.
Yeah.
Oh my God, you have your glasses on.
Yeah, I couldn't see shit.
All right, so let's talk about the movie.
So let's talk about this movie.
It sounds like you like it.
Oh my God. Netflix, I don't know, they're trying to get as much movies out for the past couple months. One of the most talked about thing is like superhero movies.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's a lot of streaming channels actually trying to jump into the whole genre of superhero movies, and sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Like the boys work, you know what I mean? And there's a few that don't work, but
like, you know, this movie,
yeah, this movie. So basically, you know, Thunder Force, it stars Melissa McCarthy
and Octavia Spencer,
as well as Jason Bateman.
So I think that, like, actually in the beginning of the movie, I'll be honest, I enjoyed the first half hour, 45 minutes of the movie. I didn't think it was like spectacular or whatever, but I enjoyed it. I liked seeing the kids. I actually thought that you could probably make a series with the kids alone.
Mm-hmm.
It kind of fed well into their grown adult personas.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that it wasn't too bad.
For me, the beginning of the movie was a little bit corny. To me, I didn't see the whole excitement about the beginning of the movie or what the relevance is about.
Okay.
The acting was queer, you know, it wasn't like round of applause type of thing.
You're not gonna get that kind of thing in this.
But it does open up for you to understand the friendship that both Melissa McCarthy has and Octavia Spencer.
Yeah.
So that kind of delves into the movie itself.
Yeah.
You know, so it gives you some sort of perspective about what it's about.
Yeah, I hear you. And I feel like that, to me, was the best part about it. The fact is, like, you will never see grown-ass women playing superheroes. Not only that, grown-ass women who are not skinny. You know what I mean? Like, I felt that I saw myself there, and I liked that.
Yeah.
That was probably the only thing, if I think about it overall, though, that I liked.
I kind of respect the fact that they did put, you know, grown women into it and allow them to play the childish idea of having this superhero thing, because not a lot of once you hear about superhero, you're talking about young kids, teenagers, such and such forth.
Or even 20 years old or something like that. Yep.
So having like older women involved in this, it's a good look.
Yes. Yes. That's about it, though.
That's about it.
Like, you know what? Because it was interesting, because I really saw, like, first of all, it's so funny because the villain Laser, who is Mantis in the MCU. So like, when she first came out, I was like, oh, this is kind of cool. Like, I want to see some more of her. And then we saw it. And then I was like, she feels like she's playing Mantis as a bad character.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I at all was not cool with it. And then that supervillain with the crab hands.
Oh, Jason Bateman.
Yeah, I was like,
you know, it's so funny, because at first when I saw Laser, I thought she was like one of the whole many characters that is going to be in the movie,
and that would make sense.
She actually is one of the main villains in it.
Yeah.
The whole story that panned onto how she became like the second villain into it.
She seemed like a rando.
Yeah, basically, because I thought she was like a random character in the movie.
Yeah, agreed.
She is a part of it. So
agreed.
And what bothers me about the movie is that Octavia Spencer and Melissa McCarthy, they have not like gained the super power ability. They literally created it. Octavia Spencer created it, and Melissa McCarthy actually got injected and she got the power. So basically, how the story was actually foreseen is like, something happened, you know, a meteorite crashed and whoever got power. So what happened to Octavia Spencer, and did what happened?
This is, first of all, coming from the man who loves Fantastic Four.
Yeah.
And they got their I understand it, but they got their powers from incident. Now I hear what you're saying. That didn't bother me at all, actually.
It's not the fact that it bothered me, it's just the fact that to what the narrative of the story when the movie started, I sensed that there were gonna be individual people that got a particular superpower just because of the meteor.
Okay.
Apparently that wasn't the case for Melissa McCarthy and Olivia Spencer.
Got it.
Okay. Olivia Spencer, the smart one, created some kind of serum or something like that, and Melissa McCarthy
accidentally sat in the chair.
And that's it.
I hear you. Now that I do agree with.
So that bothered me basically, and the main villain of the movie. Come on.
He wasn't that bad, actually.
Come on, Netflix, you got it.
He wasn't that bad. It was the crab people that I wasn't going.
Oh my God.
He had crab arms. It was dumb. It was really dumb. And I think that also goes to the comedy also, because there was not so many points that the comedy was just straight on, and then there were times where
it
like
wasn't funny.
The jokes was going on for like 2 minutes, 3 minutes to say the same exact thing, and maybe, I don't know, it was improvisation.
The movie wasn't funny.
It wasn't that funny at all.
I can't call it a comedy because I was trying to look for the comedy. I couldn't find it.
Yeah, I hear you.
Like, where's the comedy at?
I hear you.
Where's the jokes at?
Did you like the name Thunder Force at least?
The name is trash. What is it connecting to? What thunder is going on? What?
I was gonna say because Melissa McCarthy is strong, but then Octavia.
The name of the movie just don't go with.
Is invisible. So yeah.
What the movie is about, it just don't make one sense to me. It just felt like a Nickelodeon TV series.
Yes.
You know, like like one of those series that your kid would sit down and watch on Saturdays or whatever.
Nailed it.
It seemed like that to me. And trust me, I was like in the middle of this and I was sleeping.
He was, though.
This was boring.
I'm like, yo, we're gonna review it. Can you wake up?
Yeah, but I have to give a lot of big ups for Melissa McCarthy and Olivia Spencer, because in real life, they're truly good friends.
They've
been friends for over 20 years.
And they are very talented actresses. Yeah. I just don't think that this showcased their talent.
Yeah.
At all.
It didn't.
So your rating?
So my rating, before I get into my rating though, my three good and my three bad geeks about this is that in retrospect to the fact that this is like a superhero movie and to see older women involved in this and, you know, getting their kids on, the kiddie effect on, you know, I really respect that, and I can say I'm really in good terms about.
Totally agree.
My three bad geeks on the movie is that the movie was just not funny. It was just not funny. I'm trying to pinpoint what the whole excitement of the movie is. What is this movie really telling me? It wasn't telling me anything. And my last bad geek is the villains, both Laser and the king. Come on, Netflix, come on.
Yeah,
this should have gone to Nickelodeon.
I completely agree. I agree with all of yours. I think the only thing I would add on to actually a good geek is the fact that I liked the fact that Emily, which is Olivia Spencer's daughter, even though it came out of nowhere, you had no indication that this was going to happen, but that she also got superpowers too. I like that. But I'm consistent with everything you said about it, from good geek to bad geek. Like, I I'm not going to rehash it. He nailed it. Yeah. The end.
Definitely.
Like it matters.
He's going to do it out of 5. I'd give it 1 out of 5.
Nah, I'd give it at least a 2.
Yeah, I'd give it 1 out of 5 for me. It sucks.
Yeah, I don't know if I'd give it a 3, but I don't know if I'd give it a 1, so I'm going to give it a 2. Mm. This has been
Geek by Heart. I'm Jay.
I'm Lainey.
And together we make the Wonder Twins.
Stupid. Subscribe. Comment. What do you think about the movie? Did you see the movie? Did you hear about the movie? Yeah. What did you think? Let us know in the comments below. Like, subscribe, and we will see you when we see you. When we see you.
When we see you.
When we see you.
When we see you.
Okay, on the flip side.
Peace.